In this video, we're going to look at some of the aspects of aeration drying. Now, for many growers, there's a choice between hot air drying or aeration drying. With hot air gas fired, we're probably looking a matter of hours for drying. With aeration drying, in comparison, we're looking at 5-6 days for effective reduction of 3-4% moisture content. Equipment choice is very important. With aeration drying, we have a choice. We can go to purpose-built silos for aeration drying. An example is, say, a Kotzer 60-ton aeration drying set up with a three-phase 7.5 kilowatt motor, because we're looking for much higher airflows for aeration drying. The sort of airflow rates we're looking for are somewhere between 15 and 30 litres per second per tonne. This gives the reliability to aeration drying. The other choice with aeration drying is to adapt an existing silo that may have those small aeration cooling fans. In a recent trial, we actually added two 1.5 kilowatt single phase fans, F650s, that were producing flow rates of closer to 15, 16 litres of air per second per tonne in storage. So nearly half what the larger three phase fan was producing. But in both cases, we got effective aeration drying and moisture reduction for the sunflower seed. So what are the management aspects of running these fans for aeration drying? A typical schedule, if you like, for running fans is to run the fans for the first 2 to 3 days using all ambient air under 75% relative humidity. We're trying to push one drying front right through that silo. After that initial period, another 3 days of running the fans on all air under 65% relative humidity. And this achieves a good result in terms of drying the sunflower seed. So what can we expect from aeration drying? If we look at that example of the 60-ton Kotzer drying silo with the large 7.5 kilowatt fan, we placed 30 tons of sunflower seed that was ranged in moisture from 12.5% at the base when we first took off some early part of the sunflower seed through to about 9.5% moisture content at the top of the silo. Over 6 days, we removed at least 3% moisture content from all areas of that silo. That took a roughly 70 hours of fan run time. On that three-phase fan, that cost us about $140 in electricity costs. So we're looking at roughly $5 per tonne, and admittedly, remembering that took us 5 to 6 days to achieve that result. So in summary, aeration drying is a very viable way. We believe it also has possibly less risk than hot air drying. Many growers are aware who grow sunflowers of the risks of fires, both in the header or in a grain dryer. By aeration drying, we reduce that risk. And also the possibility of damaging oil quality. Excessive heat may increase those free fatty acids and damage the oil quality. With aeration drying, we believe that is a reduced risk. For further information, we would suggest you go to our storedgrain.com.au website. There's some good information sources there on aeration drying and drying in general.